All right. Let's tell Neloth the good news about Mirak being dead. Then we can head back to Raven Rock and Skyrim. Sophie, you are avenged, or at least as avenged as I can possibly make you. All right.
Yes?
What's a heartstone?
Heartstones are only found on Solstheim, as far as I know. Master Neloth believes they may be fragments from inside Red Mountain that were flung here during the huge eruption 200
years
ago.
Yes. But what are they used for? No?
Mm-hmm.
Lovely. All right. Let's tell Neloth the good news and get out of here. Giant mushroom things make me uncomfortable. Inigo, so glad you managed to find us again. Alright. Hello!
Hold still. Let me get a good look at you.
What are you looking for?
Incipient madness, loss of self-awareness, black spots in the whites of the eyes. Any of the documented indications of Hermaeus Mora's permanent influence?
Hmm.
No, you look fine. Well,
only wise to
at
check.
Least no different than when I first saw you.
You really don't need to worry about me, though. I approach these things quite practically.
I wasn't worried, just interested. I don't get to observe firsthand many people who've spoken to Hermaeus Mora.
Oh, good. So glad. I notice you haven't asked about what happened with Mirak.
Who? Oh, him. Well, I assume you killed him. Or Hermaeus Mora turned on him when you looked like the winning bet. Or a bit of both. Mirak's influence has vanished from Solstheim.
All right, bit of both.
So,
it's true.
I assumed you handled things. Why? Did something interesting happen?
Nothing particularly interesting, just the standard heroing stuff. Killing Mirak, saving Solstheim.
Well, that is what you hero types do, isn't it? I wasn't expecting anything less. Now all that's left are these black books. It's a shame I haven't located any more. So much more to be learned. Have you seen Verona? I'm hungry.
So, I'm sorry.
Have you seen Verona? I'm hungry.
What have you got for sale?
I might have a few staffs, if you're interested in that sort of thing.
I'm mostly interested in spell books. But, I am also interested in that pile of gold you have there. Because, you see, I don't have particularly much use for these. Or... this... or... oh, I'm going to go through this in a much more logical way if I do this. Okay, I'd like to keep all those. Don't need that. It was a friend's. Don't need this. Or this, this, or this. Only need one of those. I'll keep one of these because I think I can learn something from it if I go use your enchanting table. Don't really need that. I really have no use for this much dwarven oil. Or salt. Or whatever that is. And as far as these things go, I still have no idea what Heartstone is for, but I do not have any use for a ruined book. And I don't know what Stralhrim is. Stalhrim? I don't know. Anyway.
That woman is never around when you need her.
I would very much like to get into your enchanting room. And I'm not particularly impressed by the fact that... Oh, no, okay, I see. You have an enchanter here. Lovely. Glad we had that chat. Alright. And I've learned. Always a good thing. Shall we? That man is not pleasant. So, to Raven Rock.
You've got to help me. I conjured an Ash Guardian, and now it's running amok!
Alright. I can destroy it for
Thank
you.
Thank you. I was hoping you would. Hurry. I'll keep Master Neloth distracted.
Someone there.
Alright. I don't really want this to take too long. And still, I need to use a healing potion. Alright, this is no good. I keep missing. I'm far too used to other... It just vanished. How inconvenient. I was hoping it would have, I don't know, something valuable. Let's talk to the lad. Tell him he can come back out. Now. Here we are.
Have you destroyed the Ash Guardian yet? Master Neloth will kill me, or worse, if he finds out.
Yes, I destroyed the Ash Guardian.
Leaf. Master Neloth surely would have punished me had he found out. I don't have any gold to pay you with, but I can give you the staff.
All right. What have you got for sale?
So, you wish to master the arcane arts?
I really do. I'll take this, and 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 oh, interesting, this, and I suppose that's all I can convince myself, well, no, actually, it's the only useful things you have, so... Don't really want your worthless staff. Sorry. I know it was a gift, that was tactless of me. But you must admit, it was relatively worthless. Why don't you take that, and then we'll just go down the list, shall we? Don't really have need for, well, this, or either of those. Certainly not that. Nope, that looks useless to me. And you're out of gold.
I'd better get going.
I had better read my spell tomes. Well, actually, let's look at these recipes first. No, see, they don't actually list what they make. And I have little interest in guessing. Or experimenting. Alright. I am quite glad to have new spells.
Defeating Mirak was an impressive feat. I'm curious to see if Hermaeus Mora seeks you out because of it.
I certainly hope not. That was not the most pleasant encounter I have ever had with a Daedric prince. Alright. Now, truly this time, off to Raven Rock. Although, hold on a moment, let's just see what these new spells that I've learned are like. Yes, I think so. Area of effect. That's what I like. And a few other random bits. The only thing, yes, fireball deals damage, the chain lightning looks interesting, but we must be careful not to overuse electricity magics. Right, and I've also learned a little bit of extra conjuration. Interesting. Oh my goodness. Goodness. Sophia gave us this spell when we first met her. She said it would bring her to us if we had need of her. Not that we always saw eye to eye, but all right. No time to mess about, except actually time to mess about for a moment. I am interested in all of these dragon souls that I took from Mirak. Let's unlock this impressive armor. And that. And, well, we might as well use the souls we have. Excellent. And, sorry Sophie, one extra moment, just make sure that there's no additional training that the stars are willing to give us. Does not appear there's any that we need to have. All right. Let's see whether Sophie has as much forethought. Well, I can't really think who would have this much forethought. I was going to say as I, because I come back from the dead too, but that's not so much due to forethought as incredible good fortune. Well, alright, let's see if she has the same incredible good fortune as I. It appears not. Alright then. Poor girl. At least you're not in oblivion anymore.
Yes?
Right. Let's, pull you. Alright. I really don't want to just leave you there. So why don't we, for now, put her over somewhere she won't disturb all the locals. And I don't suppose she actually moved, did she? No. All right. Sophie? Good, good, good. Oh. Okay. Wow, this is incredibly morbid. Do not enjoy carrying around the bodies of my friends. Alright. Sophie, sit here. Not quite what I had envisioned, but alright. For now it will have to do. When we get back to Skyrim, we'll find a proper grave for her. Hopefully that spell works to do more than just pull her from oblivion. Hopefully it can pull her back to her homeland as well. I had really hoped that she had found a way around death. Oh, good. You know what? Alright. Oh, actually, wasn't ready for you. I think you probably are unsurprised by that.
Wrong way to kill you.
Alright. This is an ineffective use of magic. Hold on. Lightning bolt. Much better. There's more. Much harder to dodge lightning bolts as well. It's an advantage of them that you don't learn it in the College of Winterhold. Although I suppose we can teach it now, considering I probably have something to say in curriculum, right? Oh. Another. Okay. I'm going to need to ask for that, back, I think. Okay. Staff that you're now using at these random ash spawns. Oh. Good job, Sophie. I really didn't expect you to prove so adept. Alright, these ash spawn, they are really not worth charges of a unique and irreplaceable staff. There we are.
Men, an invader has entered the fort. Prepare yourselves for an ambush.
Oh, good.
Fort Frostmoth will never fall. Long live the Empire!
Alright. Not entirely sure what you mean by that. I. Not an invader. Just, you know. Dragonborn, hero of Solstheim, destroyer of bad things everywhere. Alright, I much prefer lightning to cold, I think. Alright. Good. Now that we've taken care of that, I would very much like to know what's happening with that voice saying that we need to be defended against, because I think he's probably misguided. Inigo, I see you decided to finally join us. Alright. First, I saw actually a backpack over here. A bag that will likely prove valuable. Here we are. Yes. That is actually valuable. And let's just make sure. All right. Let's investigate. I want to know who that was, and why they decided we were a threat to them. Okay, there's one entrance. And let me guess, that's the exit we'll take after we've destroyed everything inside. Right. Excellent. ash people getting destroyed, as is probably good. Don't really know what the deal is with them. The fact that they followed orders could indicate they are actually intelligent creatures, which, well, I suppose makes them attacking us on sight with any sort of, without, that is, any sort of warning or, you know, parlay, all the worse. I mean, when monsters attack you, you kind of forgive. It's not like they have a choice in the matter, but if it's an intelligent being, it's a little bit less, well, forgivable. Definitely potions about. Looks like a ruined Imperial outpost. Ah. Let's see here. Potions. Random, worthless, ash-covered armor. Worthless books. Somewhat valuable bow, but heavy. And let's see what's up top of this tower. Oh, several of the atrocities. Well, monstrosities is probably more appropriate for them to be atrocities. We'd have to say they were created, which I don't think we can assume. Not that I would be surprised if it turns out they were. Certainly. Scream. Unnatural. Much like the tentacles you're leaving everywhere, Lydia. Descend into the depths of this place. See what it is we can learn. I've learned one thing. I also learned that both of you are very good to have at your back in a fight. Oh, a letter. Selena, last letter, blah 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 blah, something happened here. Oh, lots of oblivion gates. That would be the eruption, I assume. Completely destroyed. Blah blah blah. Very sad. Oof. Defending the Empire. Oh, this letter was certainly not delivered because I'm holding it in my hands right now. That makes it much sadder. Wow. That's awful. Ugh. This... this is just... not fun. Wow. Soldier gradually becoming disillusioned and ultimately getting caught under the ash here. Just the kind of uplifting thing I like to read when... well... I mean, I suppose we are... generously investigating a mystery? More honestly, looting ruins. Oh well. All in a day's work. So boring, I can barely keep from yawning. Alright, I think I might have accidentally... okay. Let's try this. Aha! Cyrodiilic brandy. That is a fine find. Not, you know, for sale precisely. But because it will command a high price in my belly. All right. Oh. Love these spiders. Just the most adorable creatures you've ever seen. Stone, geodes, albino spider eggs. I don't find myself much caring. Spiders help with Mirak, but really I don't expect I'm going to be fighting without you both by my side and requiring, you know, spiders very frequently, so ultimately I'm unimpressed by this little spider's nest. Also, I keep forgetting when listing my accolades to everyone that I am a member of the Bard's College, but you could tell from my rhyming couplet just a moment ago. Hi. Have a face full of tentacles. Lightning. Oof. I kind of like how they just dissolve into ash. It's so much less messy than normal fights. Except, of course, for these writhing tentacle atrocities that you're leaving at really every possible place, Lydia. Every possible place.
Huh?
Glad to have confused you by ducking under your shoulders. Alright, there will certainly be more of the ash monsters in here after a moment. Because that is just how adventuring works, I've learned. And I'm really quite shocked they haven't tried to overwhelm us yet. I'm not carrying those around. Okay, someone's journal. Unearthing the crypt. Oh, general's remains. Great. Crafting heartstone. Okay, so they are constructs. Oh, goodness. Vengeance. Great. Eyes opened. And isolating yourself from good advice. Wise counsel. Oh, good. Unable or unwilling to listen to commands. Good. Self-experimentation. That's the best. I'm taking this notebook because it is a bad example to everyone. Just double check. Alright. And here's a pack, and inside we've got the key, obviously. And now that we have the key, is that the signal for them to swarm us? Doesn't appear so. Or does it? A little more dust than I would like. Oh well. So, it's the crypt, apparently, where she resurrected the general. And now that we have the key, we can open this door. Continue on our way. I expect some very... Alright. There's the general. We might as well approach with... Alright. Never mind. I was going to say we should approach with caution and understanding, and instead I'm going to recommend we approach with chain lightning. Dislike being attacked by this fellow. Okay. Yes, please get in between it and me. There we are. Everyone feeling better.
Thank you. You've been a good friend.
Why don't we make sure you are? My Anigo, you certainly took a beating. And these atrocities may be... have been... Lydia, you're alright? Excellent. Good. Okay, so here's the general. Oh, I understand why he, managed to fell you. Let's see, a note to the Imperial City. I feel qualified to read it. Third letter I'm tempted to send. Dark Elf Force. For the safety of everything. Huh. Alright. Interesting. But ultimately, I suppose someone at Raven Rock might find it a historical point of interest. Well, okay. Also, the fact that I took him down might mean they have less of these ash beasts attacking them. Maybe they'll reward me. Certainly would be nice. Now, what did the general keep here? Oh, potions. Books about pirates. And a chest, at least, with semi-valuable things. Alright. I suppose this was a worthwhile endeavor. Poor General Carius. Carius? Whatever. Poor General. Revived from the dead by a madwoman who I'm going to assume now was one of those ash monsters we saw downstairs. And he was mad. Okay. Let's continue on our way. Ah, fire. Far superior to electricity in many ways, although I may have to branch out. Because being able to hit instantly at a distance is actually quite advantageous. Much better than missing as much as I do with my fire spells. I won't pretend that I'm flawless in my aim. Now, we are heading to Raven Rock, which is somewhere on the coast. Oh, good. Ash hoppers. Lovely. But it looks like they were guarding a chest, which is now ours. Which has some valuables in it. They're like the wolves of Skyrim. Oh, good. Thank you. are. Kill the ash beasts. Were they guarding something? Uh-oh. Suppose they were. It's a shame. Oh.
I've
Lydia.
Got your back.
I actually want to trade
some
things.
How can I serve you, my thane?
I was just thinking that if you liked... you could use that. In which case... no, I suppose... well, you can choose yourself. I'll just take this back for a moment, and then I was thinking... that you might like that armor, but I suppose that's not the case. So let's just see if I... lovely. Alright.
Let's
trade some things. I just want to give you this cudgel. There you are.
You lead, I'll follow.
Let's see if you want to use that. Anyway. Suppose not, but here's Raven Rock. So hopefully we can find someone inside who will be interested in hearing about the general of the ash spawn that we just destroyed. Let's just check.
What?
Hi.
Never seen a Redoran guard before?
Well, I have, but haven't really talked to one. Anyway, I have some information about Fort Frostmoth.
You should bring this information to Captain Veloth as soon as possible. All right, then.
All right. Captain Veloth, who is over here somewhere. You are halfway into a well, but
Mordin Veloth,
I'll mind
Captain
my own business.
Captain of the Redoran Guard at your service.
I've solved your ash spawn problems.
Excuse me? How can you be so certain?
I found this letter.
Let me see that. Judging from these writings, General Curious is under the impression that the fort was still active as it was 200 years ago. And what turned him into one of the undead appears to remain a mystery for now.
Well, he's not commanding the Ash Spawn
anymore. Then
Raven
Rock will no longer be attacked by those creatures. Councillor Morvane was offering quite a bounty for assistance with this matter. I'd say you've more than earned it.
Thank you very much. That's nice.
I'm sorry to bother you, but Second Councillor Rano asked me to come find you. He said it's quite urgent.
Did he say what it was about?
All he wanted me to do is track you down and send you to him. Look, this is important. Even more important than wiping out the ash spawn. Please, go speak to the Second Counselor as soon as possible.
I actually was just going to ask you if you knew or had any ideas about who could...
always a pleasure to watch when a man like you walks by.
Uh-huh. Alright. Well, Counselor.
Thank you for coming. After everything you've already done for Ravenrock, I hate to ask for more, but I can't risk Councillor Morvane being killed.
He's in danger of that? How?
The Ulan family of House Lalu, a rival great house, has placed a death mark on the Councillor's head.
Why would they want him dead?
It's a private matter. Let's just say they seek revenge for the execution of one of their own, ordered by Councillor Morvane himself. The problem is, I don't have any solid proof that anyone from House Lalu is hidden among us. Only my suspicions.
All right, so perhaps your concerns are justified. What would you have me do about it?
It may be justified, but it certainly isn't appreciated. Councillor Morvain simply feels that I'm being paranoid. I'm afraid that one day I'll awaken and discover him dead. And I don't want it to come to that.
Well, at least he'll be promoted. So, you feel an attack on him is imminent?
I do. I've received some information from my sources that there could be elements of Ulan's house, House Lalu, already in Ravenrock.
Why haven't you acted on this information?
Ravenrock is a small settlement, so it's hard to accomplish anything in secret. If any of them is from House Lalu, I wouldn't be able to make a move without them knowing.
So, how can I help?
I had a feeling you'd be willing to listen to me.
All right, again, how do I help?
I need you to start out by being my eyes and ears. Search Ravenrock. See if you can root out these traitors. The best place to start would be Geldis Sadri, over at the Retching Netch Corner Club. If he provides you any leads, check them out before bringing them to my attention. Can't afford to make any mistakes.
All right.
Don't worry. You can trust Geldis. He's been with us for a long time.
You got a good thing going here now that you've reopened.
Have you got anything to
say? Take a look.
I'm glad to see you've restocked since last I was here. And it would seem you've restocked with largely junk. Yes. Largely junk. Well, good for you. I can help replenish your stock. Now, see, I would very much... but I also don't want to be lugging it around with me all the time. Which I suppose is... not really negotiable. Unless I bring it all the way back to my home... well... my rooms at the College of Winterhold.
Bring your weapons and armor to me.
It's going to take a little while. I have to resolve this matter first.
Can't believe I've been stuck here this long.
All right. Let's solve a mystery.
Welcome to the Retching Netch Corner Club, home of the finest Sioux jammer that will ever grace your lips.
Adril Arano said you might be able to help me.
Well, well. Adril's got himself a spy, does he? Azura knows he needs all the help he can get. He's been chasing the Ulans for years now. And I'm supposed to run my
operation outside. Do you think he's mistaken?
No. I don't think so. I just think he's going about this the wrong way.
What's your idea?
Actually, I do. If you want to catch those slippery slaughterfish, you need to let them come to you.
How would I get them to do that?
There's an Ulan ancestral tomb near the temple. Someone's been leaving ash yam offerings on the altar inside. If you were to wait inside for whomever that is, I'm betting they'll have some of the answers you're looking for.
And why am I the first one to hear this?
What makes you think I have it?
Anytime Adril and the Redoran Guard made a move, the Ulans must have been one step ahead and didn't show up.
Thanks for the tip.
You can thank me if it works. Until then, I'd head to the tomb and wait until your visitor shows up.
Come back any time. My doors are always open.
I actually have a
question. The mine's open, people are buying drinks, and I'm making money again. Just like
old
times. Why
did Counselor Morvain execute an Ulan?
Back in 95, Vela Ulan came to Ravenrock with a plan to take over our town. The Fetcher thought he could stir up the locals and use them against the Redoran Guard, and then murder Counselor Morvain when we weren't looking.
Vela did this alone?
He arrived alone, but spread enough coin around to start changing people's minds. Half the bloody town joined his side. Can you believe that?
How did he get caught?
He underestimated the Redoran Guard. They were organized and brought a swift end to the coup. Vela tried to run, but he was caught by Captain Veleth himself. Vela Ulan was executed a short time later, and his remains placed in the Ulan ancestral tomb.
Well, good to know.
Come back any time.
Good day.
My doors are always open.
All right. As I said before, let's go solve a mystery.